Hi, children. Welcome back to XCOM, and we're doing Target Escort this time. I've also upgraded my Long War II version F, 14F. And if you want to know what's changed, there was a major bug in the version, the two versions I was playing there, actually, the ones that you see me do for YouTube. Apparently, whenever the aliens do any kind of resource gathering missions, this is just from what I've described. When they do resource gathering missions or something like that, they'll spend resources trying to get materials, and if they're successful and bring them back, they won't get anything out of it. Meaning that they're infinitely, spending the resources they do have on trying to get resources that they can never receive back, and have completely fucked up their AI. I'm not sure what the implications of that are. It sounds like it made it easier, although I certainly don't feel like that was the case, because I played an earlier version of the mod, and it wasn't easier now. It's not even easier now. I find it quite challenging all the same. It may not make a difference until maybe a couple months later, because I'm still relatively early on in the game where that impact may not have really been noticeable. That's my assumption anyways. But I've applied the patch that fixes that, and I'm not going to restart, although I should in order to get a balanced game, but I'm just letting you know that's exactly what's happened here, so I'm going to try and, like, truck on regardless.
We look forward to seeing your progress.
Because, as I said, now I've essentially started with a handicap, I guess, but they may have also balanced the game around that. I don't know. But I'm going to just keep trucking along, as I said. I'm not feeling inclined to restart, even though, yeah, this is pretty hard. This mission I've already failed, like, three times, and I'm finding it to be very difficult. This is actually, we know this mission. It's the guy that's supposed to come back with us. We're supposed to escort him. So, I am finding it hard, so I'm going to bring along some of my really good people. Well, we got Daryl for overwatching. We got our infantry here for infantrying. Pretty much just like a lot of like really pro people. We got our best sniper along as well for the ride, which is going to be good. I'm bringing along our engineer with the Arc Thrower. Just, you know, if there's an opportunity, I'll seize it, basically. And also our scout's coming along with max armor and all that, because the scout is actually, in my first attempt at this, I didn't bring along a scout, and that was a horrible idea. But I think we'll be good now, and we're going to strategize a lot. And also probably not hit cancel when I'm about to do it. Let's go. XCOM ho, and it's over there. This is not even a terror mission, it's just like some shit.
Dropship has arrived.
I don't even know what it is.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States.
Oh yeah. So, it's this map.
The VIP for this operation goes by the name of William Thorne. He's an influential politician suspected of collusion with the aliens. We need you to bring him in alive for questioning. Get him to the Skyranger for evac. Objectives updated.
So, first things first. This alleyway is literally death. Every time I've gone down here, it's been hell. So I have a couple of options. This building up here doesn't have any ladder access, unfortunately, so that's a problem. I do see there's kind of a route down here, which is kind of nice. Unfortunately, the windows are kind of like in the way, and so it's probably gonna like trigger a bunch of aliens. And ultimately, the point of this mission is we're just trying to bring the guy back there. So I'd probably prefer not going around to where the windows are. Believe it or not, I'm actually gonna take the roof. This is my first time actually attempting this little strategy, but I think it's for the best. And so, my sniper actually, because of our low grapple ability here, we can actually just go up there right now. I've actually tried bringing the sniper onto that roof, but when the sniper is isolated, it actually bad things happen, so... shit gets even worse. Oh, and we have a ladder, like, right here, so that also helps. So the sniper's just kinda covered down here, and also kind of around here. And my whole plan for this section here is to just have everybody up here, and the gunner is gonna have to basically do a double move anyways, so... Question is, where should you go? I want the gunner eventually to kind of go to that one, but... I mean, you have squad sites, so it doesn't really make a difference. And our infantry, I would rather have him shoot, but he simply does not have enough turns.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Where is this laser guy going to go? Now, technically, the grapple wasn't really necessary. I just wanted to show it off, mostly, because I could have just sprinted up here, you know? But whatever.
Moving to position.
And we have our medic now with the smoke grenades, so that's kind of nice. I'll come in handy, I'm sure.
On the move.
This is absurd! Do you honestly think I would turn my back on my country? I am not a traitor, dammit!
I field, Commander.
Alright. And... just gonna overwatch here.
Strike one. X-rays are making their way to your position.
So the very first thing that happens here is apparently nothing, and you can also hear mutons on the map, so you can kind of tell why I'm doing this little strategy here. All right, so already as it is, he's going to go into Overwatch. Don't kill him. Okay, good. He's not dead, which is a really excellent thing because we don't actually have a thin man autopsy yet. Damn, I'm just a little bit short. Here's my thinking. I'm just going to go activate his thing with lightning reflexes. Apparently, I got hit anyways. Lightning reflexes isn't a guarantee. But it's interesting all the same. Alright, we're going to hit him with this thing.
You have no right to do this. I work for the people. On whose authority do you operate?
Right, I'm planning on suppressing him, and we're gonna go up here, and we're gonna just basically hunker everybody down.
Heading to that location.
Try and spread these people out a little bit. Sniper can just steady aim. I'm doing this because I'm trying to get a turn in.
Hostiles inbound. Stay frosty.
I'm hoping he just freezes up or something. Or just shoots at someone that's not important. Let's see what he does. Ah, well. Okay, he decided to take a shot.
He's down.
Or move or something. That's unfortunate. Alright, we got one over there. That's a shame. Thin men are kind of hard to capture. Alright, well, we got more hostiles inbound. I guess we might as well just go kill them all. Fine. Alright, he's active now. I mean, it's a really easy shot, so... like, these are easy kills because they're just an Overwatch.
I will not speak to anyone until I'm given proper legal representation!
Guy's so annoying. Like, after doing this mission 3 times, I am so fucking annoyed by him now. Alright. Now here's a question. Do I keep my sniper here? Because there is potential for someone to... come behind my sniper, which isn't the best. Guess we'll kind of go... We'll kind of keep her covered. You can go just fuck off back there. I mean, there's gonna be enough people in Overwatch watching your back. Honestly, I should probably give that person a heal, but...
That op zone is about to get hot. Hostiles are inbound to your location.
I mean, once we bring them up there, it's gonna be, like, super easy. At this point. Oh, there we go. This is why we kept the sniper in the back. Look at this, 100% chance to hit, 95% chance to crit. Yeah. We didn't see that coming. Alright, I kind of want to heal this person with my, my gentleman here. Alright. Where is my medic? Medic will just go right beside him.
Got it. Moving. Ich hab mich los.
Kind of just moving people up into more opportune positions. Overwatch gunner. The Rocketeer can probably just stay here, just in case someone comes up there.
Scanning.
I hate how like the it keeps disappearing everything here. All right, and we're gonna reload our rifle here. Never know when we'll need it. Knowing me, probably sooner than later. Yeah, this is someone over there. Yeah, okay, so Overwatch. Alright. Here's where things turn slightly bad. We got a couple mutons there, but fortunately for us, we have quite a number of capable people here. And we activated another group, I think. There's three groups. And you can kind of see why things went wrong. Alright, so he's on the other roof, it looks like. First one we start with is the sniper. The sniper does not have a shot. This makes it for some very tough decisions then. Oh, we have a shot here, so we'll just study here. Alright. This unfortunately means we're gonna have to move this guy all the way back. Potentially here. Because I don't want him getting shot at, so he's gonna go back with our sniper. Now, these two guys are not in good spots.
In bewegung.
We can fortunately kind of move people back though. Hope my medic has more movement than that. Nope. She does not.
Target confirmed. On our way.
So she's gonna have to sprint. Now, this could be kind of problematic of seeing if he goes there, he can potentially just get a shot off on us. And also it's the problem of the people coming up there, so we're gonna just kind of move him back here. And now we can't actually see anybody, which is good. This is a good thing.
Moving to position.
It means they're gonna have to come to us. We have a lot of overwatches to let them kind of just walk right into. Now, as I said, imagine fighting that in that fucking alley down there. It was fucking awful. There's actually a lot of good cover on this roof. But the plan is just to let them come into us. Because fuck everything else.
You'll be back in the fight ASAP.
Alright. I mean, we actually have a really strong Overwatch group here. Now, unfortunately, we don't actually get to see the other guy. But what we'll do is we'll bring this guy to trigger him. Okay, there's a major fucking group there. Where's my Rocketeer? Yeah, it's pretty fucking awful. Alright. I probably should have studied aim with her, but it's a little late for that now.
With pleasure.
There you go.
Positive enemy contacts.
And you panicked. Wait, why did he... We activated another group, actually. Oddly enough. And why were you in Overwatch? I wasn't done with my turn yet. What the fuck? And you're panicked now? What? Why is everyone panicking? What even happened here? I don't even know. Alright. I'm very confused. Alright, we got 100% chance to crit with this guy over there, so we're gonna just take him out. Oh, this is a trick shot through the fucking ventilation there. Oh, and we also have another shot, that's right. We'll judge that a little bit later. For the time being, actually no, maybe we'll do that right now. We don't want to shoot with him, I think. We want to kill that one. But if we shoot with him, we'll miss our basically two Overwatch shots. So I think we don't have a choice, actually. We have to shoot with him. Alright.
No longer.
Guy's gonna have to reload. And the sniper's gonna take one more shot, because this is our double tap sniper now. This one's a very good chance to kill, so we're gonna go for kills right now. My plan with our scout is to move the hell back. He did his job. and Sunker. It's a little bit weird how people like decided to panic at this best time. This is why we brought some of our best along here. Alright. We have an Overwatch. Which means, luckily this time we do not actually have to move anywhere. 61, so these are basically all the same shots. Does he have Opportunist? No. He does have an Opportunist. Oh well. It doesn't actually tell me. I don't know until I shoot, which is odd. I thought the game is nice enough to tell me, but it isn't. It doesn't look like. Alright. Laser, Shatter Ray. Our lasers and stuff kind of not useful right now, but be okay. Alright. He only has one thing to do. He has to reload and then Overwatch because he gets two shots. No shot there. We could fire off another rocket, but I prefer not to. Well, it looks like we may not have many options here. He's killed him back there. Okay, he's gonna do nothing but hunger down. Now here's my problem. I want to shoot this guy down, but we're not in range. The Rocketeer. So if I go over here, I can then shoot him. There we go. Alright, just two more Overwatches for when this guy inevitably moves up. Oh, no, it's gonna be someone else that moves up. No, that works for me. This is why we reloaded him. I just wish we had another clip, and when with ammo conservation, we'll get that clip. Alright, so this, I'm pretty sure that this, my engineer is going to be reloading during her turn. So now we're going to move over here and see what we've got here. Alright, there's nobody over there, so in the interest of not pissing anybody off, I'm going to go reload everybody. That was actually a perfect amount of ammo, to be honest. Moving. Let's do this. Probably could have reloaded him, actually. It just occurred to me, because I just ended his turn with Overwatch. Man, this keeps hiding everything. It's really awkward. Alright, let's have a look. There he is. Did the sniper get him? Yeah, sniper has him, so it becomes more of a question of shooting with this guy. Nope. Miss. We'll just kill him with the sniper. Sniper has double tap. It's a bit of a waste, but what the hey? This is what the sniper's. This is why we brought the sniper. Just for situations just like this. All right, reload. And Overwatch. I think this worked out pretty well so far. Might be speaking too soon though. Now there are mutons down here somewhere, which is always the best. Alright, let's go back here and give everybody a reload now. Yeah, let's get ready to go then. Wouldn't mind also, like, getting the heater. And there's definitely someone on the other side there. We'll move up again with our fancy ass. This guy is invaluable, I swear to God. Alright, there's no one up here. Let's see what we got. Gunner could easily kind of just move over here. Time to motor. And I'm not against that. Overwatch, I'm more just petrified if they decide to come out again. He's probably on the roof or down there. We got all the floaters. I'm not sure why the mutons didn't actually. Oh, there they are. Well, this guy's fucked them. Later. He's down. I was just about to say, I'm not sure why the mutons didn't just come up here. But, alright, that works for me. I mean, they've got one ladder here, and that's it. Like, they have to come up here, and they're gonna get bored. Alright, let's move it away. Which, protects the most amount of people. This is not good for the medic, actually. We're gonna move her up here. Because I'm just worried that someone's gonna flank from that side. You know the floaters? Like, that's like the perfect, like, floater angle. I'm gonna keep this guy here, though. I like my infantry being there. Because he gets a lot of, basically, angles to shoot people. I am slightly worried about this ladder. But we'll see how that goes. We don't really know where they are. Well, I'm pretty certain that they're going to keep trying to come up. I'm going to move my rocketeer probably now. Let's poke over here and see what we see. There is nobody here. Okay, that's good to know. And so the rocketeer, your infinite grace, will go over here. Reload, just to make sure everybody's okay.
Okay.
Just start having people head around. All right. This fella's gonna run over there. The rooftops is honestly the best idea. I'm saying that now, but you have no idea how horribly things went wrong when I wasn't on the rooftops. Okay, this is my sniper is now the closest person to the threat now, which isn't good. It means that they're probably planning on coming up that ladder. Hey, you'll do fine there. Don't worry.
Copy that.
So I'm actually gonna move this guy over here. And my rocketeer can also come over here.
I'm on it, Commander.
And it does mean that I'm gonna move my sniper back here.
Roger that, scanning.
I feel, Commander.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Now if I bring this guy over here, I can likely just jog him over there. How will he be able to? I'm thinking about moving with someone else, like the scout first, to trigger overwatches. And I just have to have a place. He's the closest one now? Well, that's not good. Well, he actually doesn't give a shit, so. Alright, so we're gonna now move him over here. And it's gonna be one more dash, and he's free then. He might be really far away, you know. I just like the fact that the civilian can basically go and go like, oh, I think I hear them over there.
We're picking up some strange readings near your op zone. Keep an eye out for hostile forces.
Yeah, I think we're gonna have him run out in the open. We're picking up some strange readings, he says. Oh, he's dead. Oh, please, please. No! If he had 1 HP, I could have gotten him with the thing. Alright. Alright, do your shit, scout. Oh, there's a muton there. We didn't capture muton yet, did we?
Where are you taking me? I demand answers!
Great, good shot. Let's destroy his cover. He's intimidated. Intimidating. You don't even see who did that. You can't intimidate. Alright, let's have a look. You're definitely gonna overwatch. You're definitely gonna steady your aim. If I go here, that's a really kind of bad angle for us to be in. I'm just hoping he kind of like kind of moves this way or something. Because my engineer is a good spot to basically stun his ass, so.
Heading to that location.
Or comes up top. That actually wouldn't be that bad either. Oh. No, continue the mission. Oh, I have to bring him with me? Wait a second, I thought he just goes inside the Sky Ranger. Oh, there's another muton.
They're trying to pull back.
Okay. Well, let me just verify the guy is. Okay, good. He's gone now. That's what I thought it's supposed to do.
Good. Now you just need to take out any active hostiles still in your locale.
I'm not gonna lie, this is not the ideal situation to basically try and take a muton, because there's two of them. I thought there was only one. Yeah, we can't even hop down on top of him, so. And there are two ladders here. Both ladders are not ideal. I might just run back here, but I actually don't know what's there. I don't know. We could shoot down with some people. Fine. Judge it, medic. We got some good shots here. I'll say that much. What was my infantry see?
I'm on it, Commander.
That's a good shot. You see a 12 crit. That's what we're talking about. Where's my medic? I thought I had those grenades, which I could use to basically stun him. So I'm thinking about keeping this guy right where he is, actually. As crazy as that sounds. Gunner is not very useful there. Sniper is not very useful here. So my plan is to basically just kind of fuck him over. And then kind of come down on the last guy. We're gonna have to heater him. We'll probably have to kill the last one. So this is where we pray that the last one doesn't crit us. I'm just gonna put him in a more useful position. And you can go up here. Okay, let's see what he does. He's gonna go into there. Alright, he's kind of running around. Debating what to do now. I wanna try and capture this one. Also prefer not to kill him, which is hard to do, actually.
Heading out. Allá voy.
Alles wieder im grünen Bereich. All right. Make some reloads, and we're gonna pray to hell that he doesn't come up here and flank anybody. I'm gonna overwatch just that person to make sure that doesn't happen.
Back in.
Yeah, let's see what happens now. Alright. Where's my scout? Get in there. We don't even know what happened to him.
Moving out.
Oh god, he ran into there, didn't he? Alright, engineer. Get on. Oh, there he is. We can go like right over here. Alright. Overwatch him. Guess I'll overwatch him in case he goes over there. And Hunter. This is the most dangerous game, trying to fucking bait a muton. There he is. Oh god. Don't kill him. Please don't kill him. okay. He's running this way, which is retarded of him, so.
Okay.
Alright, I think I've cornered him up there. This has been really dumb. Like, I've just decided to skip this all out, but like, put this all out because it's like, fuck. He's basically running back to some thin man that was in the back there. So, I've tried to make this as safe as humanly possible. I'm sufficiently annoyed by the- there he is.
Sie treten den Rückzug an.
This has been fucking ridiculous. Okay. You fucking panicked! The person with our items fucking panicked. Oh my fucking Jesus.
I'm rolling.
Got something over here.
Yeah, we know he's here. We don't want the thin man. Get the fuck out. So, because of this fact, we have to try and now kill him. And
got it covered.
We're probably just gonna have to overwatch here.
On my way.
If I overwatch with this one, he's probably dead, so fuck that. Just hunker down.
Ideal, Commander.
Overwatch if they come out here. Just run back outside, please. Oh, you got fucking acided? Alright, this may be our opportunity. He's got one HP. This could not be better for us right now, the way this turned out. I swear to God, if you don't get stunned, I'm leaving. Fucking hell. Asshole. Yeah, let's just hope he hunkers down. He shouldn't have an option. He should just stay where he is, or else like he's gonna die. Stay, just hunker down. Yes, yes, he hunkered down. Oh my God, this is the fucking best. Yay, we did it.
Mission accomplished, folks.
Oh.
Grab in and head for home.
I fucking hate this game. That was really hard though, but we managed to pull through.
An exemplary performance. Let's hope all of these operations go as smoothly as this one did.
All right, so here's our options here. So we have we're making like an offensive, like defensive medic mainly. So we got suppression here, which is I guess not the worst idea. It adds some utility, but it'll use like most of her clip if she does that. We have smoke and mirrors, which is more grenades during the mission. And then we have field surgeon. So you can has a 75% chance to reduce or eliminate recovery time for non-critically wounded soldiers. I forget what it counts. I forget what counts as a critically wounded soldier. I think it's like 1 or 2 HP. It's like 25% health. I don't really know. I don't fucking quote me on that. But basically, it has to be below armor damage, but above what is almost dead. Or if they got down, that's also critically wounded. If they got down, that's maybe that's what it is. So if they got like health damage, then it reduces the time. I'm gonna take a smoke and mirrors actually, because this is enables one additional use of all any support grenades. Even the ones she has equipped. And this one here, oh wow, our scout leveled, so. This one was just gonna be like, he's not actually supposed to be using that strike rifle, but whatever. Resilience, I think, is what he's going to use, simply because he gets shot at a lot. As much as I like the idea of vital point targeting, I'd rather have him with resilience.
Another live capture? Please give my thanks to the main commander. I know it can't be an easy task trying to bring them in alive. You can trust that the research team will make it worth the trouble.
The motherfucker was running away from me the entire time.
We will be in touch, Commander.
Alright. What do we have for facilities? Yeah, oh, by the way, I totally regret now not building just a fucking, a thermal generator here, because I wasted so much space with these fission generators. I had no idea I'd be doing that. So I immediately regretted that. I apologize greatly. I realize that now. I'm guessing the videos I put up of me doing that haven't gone up yet, but I'm just guessing I'm gonna take a lot of shit for that, and I totally deserve it, because it wasn't a good idea. I think we're good. We're gonna just actually keep spinning the globe. Oh, they took a lot of money, so We're not gonna do. Oh wait, wait, whoops. No, no, I wanna launch a covert operation. Sorry, I forgot. Should Biggie go? Probably not. Let's bring a newer assault, like Wolf Guy. He can go. He's got as long as they have at least Gunslinger, they're good to go, in my humble opinion. And let's see. HE grenade. And I do want to actually show you something.
XCOM operative deployed against Exalt position in the United States.
Which one is the medic that we had that was a part of that mission? This one was. So she now has the perk for that. I don't know what. Well, okay, before she had armor there. What I should have given her actually is. Where is it? These new grenades that I haven't really used that much. She gets two of them now, which is really good. And they act like flashbangs now, too. So, that's amazing. So they take damage and they're like flashbangs. So this is kind of loadouts I'm gonna have on my medic, kind of just like this. So that's my plan. All right, let's go back to spinning the globe. I just want to show you that actually counts as a support grenade.
Commander, our satellite is prepped and standing by for launch. We are ready to deploy it on your orders.
A 15 thin men for a new scout sniper corporal. Yeah, what are we gonna do with thin men corpses? So who's our new soldier here? It would be Corporal is, I guess it's William Nelson Bishop. Is this one in my file? Should be. And so I can either, well, actually I have two new people. So that's one of the new people. I forgot that I get two. We're gonna get a grenader. And this one's gonna be another, well, I was making a support grenader before. We can use another damage one, I suppose. Heat warheads on that. And who's the other one? We got James Nick Burns. No, this is now using the old names file, actually. Fuck. Because I patched the game. So this could be my clot. I just decided this. I have to set a name. Now you can't remove the name, which is really dumb. Well, this is not a sniper though. We need a sniper, that's me. This can be a, I don't, fucking hell. Like, why do they force me to do this? I don't know. I'm gonna call them poopers. Poopers asswipe. Balls. There you go. Poopers balls asswipe. The best and most mature names here. So here's Mike Lott. And my nickname will be Yoshi, sure. Just because that's my avatar in every case. Mike Lott Yoshi. Apparently I'm British. So because I'll be a scout. I'll be the scout sniper just because. I'll be another scout sniper just because it's like, yeah. So damn good ground with Lone Wolf. So I'm gonna make this person into a scout sniper as well. Just because I really like the playstyle. And I'll replace the name for the next episode because I didn't realize it. I thought I looked at it and it looked fine. Apparently it got overwritten, so I'm sour now, again. Oh wow, we have fucking negative 220. Nap of Earth, large transport. I'm gonna actually hard save and save scum it because I'm actually wondering, I've never actually tried to shoot down a transport UFO. So let's actually check out what happens when we do. If it's possible at this point. I mean, it's on the Nap of Earth, which means it's gonna land real soon.
Closing on target. Disengaging.
Okay, I'm gonna try to do that again, except he's gonna be defensive. Cause I was curious, so they do a lot of damage with those weapons, so, and we have a lot of time. Two things I didn't really realize. I'm gonna give him a really low chance of hitting us, and we'll see how that works out. Because shooting this down actually would be really nice, because then it'll kill most of the things on there. God damn it. I don't even think it's worth it to try and shoot it down. That's one of those things.
Contact detected.
Detected.
How would balance do? How many shots does he even require to be shot down with a laser? This is my last attempt, by the way.
Hangs out.
And then I'm just gonna wait for him to land.
Closing on target.
Oh, he got shot down. Well, fuck it. Alright, we're just gonna ignore it and let it land. I was curious. I'm sorry.
Contact detected.
Yeah, just can't. Alright, we're sending us something after that. Probably some of these other people that are fatigued still. How many days do I have? I wonder. Once again, going to save Scummit. Is this even save scumming? I don't even know. Alright, let's see. Oh, is there satellite nexus? I think there's badass as fuck. Okay, no, we have absolutely no time to wait for them to come back, so we're gonna just actually kind of force them to go on that mission. And it's another large UFO, so this should be really, really entertaining. But I'll decide who goes on this mission for next time, so remember, we will be watching.